5 minutes past.
Yeah. 2 days, we should be lucky.
Let's go.
We should be lucky.
I think maybe we start from the matching.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. former university emeritus professor S. C. Akin for the
Chief Professor Mwaka Ifamono.
We have the head of the campus here, Professor Ilichukwu. We have our deans and directors. Deans and directors, I will fulfill this call again. We ask you to hand a microphone to all the university to invite the Vice Chancellor.
Very welcome, sir. In a special Why he has
So the Christian is a blessing. That is opening what we are going to hear. Let us just relax and listen to the number lecturer as he gives us this particular lecture. Thank you for the rest of us. Thank you, our Vice Chancellor. It's a request. We put our hands again for the Vice Chancellor. Vice Chancellor, please permit me to recognize the companionship of the Honorable Lecturer, Chief of Caribou, Pastor Bolivar, Honorable Engineer Manuel Owen Sukri. It's a nice time for the Minister. Chief of the Pastor. We also have Chief Imamwe, Chief JP. Chief Imamwe, JP, welcome, sir. Professors also have a representative from Federal University Yola, Professor Andrew Abu. We are invites the University Public Professor Isaac Zepp for a citation.
Here networks of centers, research centers and institutes, heads of departments, emeritus professors that are here, distinguished professors and all
academic
administrative and technical staff, students of this great university. Students of this great university, BOSA. Special guests, friends, admirers, associates, well wishers, my loves, spiritual and temporal. Gentlemen of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you are all welcome to the 84th inaugural lecture, titled Time, Lives and Families. The next before and after bags, fighting medicinal impacts. Now, anatomy as a discipline is an old discipline. It's a discipline that has a history. The term by a Greek anatomist and Latin means the section, that is the correct word, the section system means cutting up. Now, at the early stage of anatomy involvement, it was really, really cutting up the human bodies to study the previous parts of the body. Now, these two men, Theophilus and Hippocrates, were famous in the 4th century BC. Theophilus identified anatomy as a discipline, whereas Hippocrates, an ancient Greek physician, referred to anatomy as a science. And the man that is really important in the annals of anatomy is Andreas Vesalius. He did a lot of dissections to demonstrate the systematic ways the body structure functions into topographical nature. Now, anatomy as a science has subdivisions. The latest subdivisions was defined by the associations of anatomists, known as IFA, IFA is an African international association of associations of anatomists. And this is a classification about 11 models. Now, for the purpose of this lecture, I want to model all together into three categories. That is the gross anatomy, microscopic anatomy, and the developmental anatomy. Gross simply means what can be seen with the physical eyes. Gross anatomy is the structure, the spatial structure of the body, as it relates to the environment. Now, the developmental anatomy is the early stages of development of the human body from conception up to birth. And that is what we call the developmental anatomy. Microscopic anatomy is what is observed under the microscope. Today I am focusing on microscopic anatomy because that is what I keep observing. Under the microscope, my study instrument is the microscope. Now, tiny lives, as the name suggests, are structures that cannot be seen with the naked eye. They must be observed by the microscope. And there are two types of microscopes, the light and the electron microscope. The light microscope can observe little, but the little microscope observes much more. There are different types of divine atmosphere, as we said. For one, each of them has its own unique function. For example, the face compass is used to observe living cells or living tiny lives, particularly the phase of cell division. Now, these figures represent the light and the electron microscope. Now, the electron microscope has a lot of advantages over the light microscope. If you use the light microscope and you use also the electron, you will know a great advantage the electron has over. Now, there are some terms that I want to define. One is resolution. Now, we cannot understand the structure of the cell if we don't define the terms of relationship. Now, resolution is assuming two structures under the microscope are brought close. A term comes when the two structures are so close that they are not separated. Now, resolution is the smaller distance that separates the two structures as separate and distinct. Now, the light microscope has a resolution of about 0.2 micrometers. A micrometer is one part of a million meter. It's very, very small. Now, the electron microscope does much more. It resolves to as much as 0.0002. That is about 1,000 times the capacity of the light microscope. Now, the other definition of terms is magnification. Microscope enlarges the absolute size of structures. And so, the light microscope can enlarge as much as 1,000 times, whereas the electron microscope can enlarge well over 200,000. So the advantage of the electron microscope cannot be overemphasized. The other term is contrast. When you observe structures under the microscope, if there is no contrast or contrasting medium, they cannot easily be seen because structures under the microscope by the arrangement of the tissues, they cannot easily see their translucent under the scope. So normally, structures are directed by biological means, or if it is the electron microscope, heavy metals. For the operation of the electron microscope, you will use heavy metals, or the light microscope, biological dyes are used to be able to select and ensure that there is good contrast. Now, these three principles are very important in understanding the structure. Now, this is a young man's piece in a research laboratory in Ghana to have the citation or the citation. Most of my lecture work was done in Ghana. And that is one of the opportunities for the Nigerian services that are available. And tiny lives and families. Tiny lives simply means the building blocks of the body structure. And they are simply the cells. Now, families are the conglomerate, the aggregate units of these cells into tissues and organs. So family and tiny lives and family simply means the cells and their aggregate composite structures into tissues and organs. And that is why we name evolve. Tiny lives and families. From now I will be using the tiny lives and family. Now, before that, life begins. a male sex cell fuses with a female sex cell. They come together and that fusion is what is referred to as fertilization. Now, secondly, you can illustrate the process. The diagram on the right extreme and left side that the tiny life is sex cells that come together, the male and the female sex cells.
Need to monitor
the one thing that distinguishes the cells is that the male sex cell has XY chromosomes. Now for the fusion, if the X chromosome is fused with the X chromosome of the female, and the outcome will be a female. But when the Y chromosome fuses with the X chromosome of the female, the outcome will be a male. Now the female chromosomes, the sex cell chromosomes, they are just one pair, and the pair is X, both are X. XX for the male is XY. In addition to the particular sex cell, I mean chromosomes, there are other chromosomes because the total number will be established, that is 46, 23 paternal, 23 maternal. You bring together 26. But the addition is 22. Chromosome that body cells and one single sex cell. And that is the union that brings the two together. Now, for every ejaculate, there are 1,100 million sperm. Sperm is simply the male sex cell. Is such that 25% may be immortal. Is they move by the motility of the chase. 25% will be immortal, and another 20% may be morphologically dysfunctional. I'm making just about 50% that are actively functional, both structurally and functionality. Now, out of this also, there are cases in families that have issues, infertile couple. Now, what is it that is causing infertility? Part of it is the cells, I mean the male sex cells that are not capable of, or the female egg. Now it is required that one half base number of male sex cells is expected to be fertilized. Now, F. stadia is a product of just one sex cell from the male fertilizing the female. Each person has that opportunity to be because one sex cell, of the male has fertilized the ovum. Now, this, I need to emphasize the fact the determination of male or female. And let it be very clear that it is the man that contributes to the sex of the individual. It's not the woman. So let us blame the women less. The men are responsible. If you do not have the right chromosome, you cannot have the male. The other made a success. Now, you can see there's a proportion. For everyone made a female success, the overall production for the male is 4. Usually, in the process of spermatogenesis and eugenesis, the overall output will be 2 on the maternal side and 8 on the maternal side. That means the ratio is 1:4. Now this is the light cell that arises as a result of fusion of male and female gametes, known as the zygote. Now, further divisions of the zygote, this time around is not is maintaining the 46 chromosome. They divide mitochondrially. Now, the first stage is 2 cells division, then 4 cell stage, 8 cell stage, where it's called the gonula, and then about 6 cell stage, where it's blastocyst. Now, the blastocyst are the secretions from the uterus, has the cells invaded by the fluid secretions of the uterus, and they are divided into 2 categories, inner group and outer group. And the blastocyst, up to the time of the blastocyst, very important to note that each of these cells is a transition, and then the processes are done outside. And a good sperm is introduced to the egg, and fertilization will take place, and it will allow the stage of blastocyst, as you can see, until it is at that stage before it is now introduced to the woman. And it is also expected that there are 60-70% chances fertilization and the lifting of the baby. So this technology is important because of the isolated study of time lapse. Now time lapse and families after birth. Each cell has capacity to live communities. And it is this group of communities that form the tissue. And they decide to flow in communities and run in disasters to form this plan. And that is not good to be alone. For this plan. And it's not good to be alone. In 2 persons, of course, one will help the other. Together, they form a number of other structures. They are the cells or the tiny cells that cover the cell. Let's say, for example, the skin that covers the cell and the corner of the eye, total. The outer layer of the skin, the epidermis, and the corner of the eye together, they are product of epithelium. Connective tissue are supporting tissues, like the bones, the cartilage. The adipose tissues are fat tissues. All these are products of connective tissues. For muscular tissues, they refer to the muscles of the body. The muscles attached to the bones, and some muscles that are known as skin muscles. They do not attach to bones, they function independently outside the knowledge of the individual. For example, the inner and visceral muscles that lines the hollow organs, the digestive organ, the respiratory organ, the urinary organ, the reproductive organs, These organs are lined by muscles and a material that are independent in function of the organ, and they are controlled by a system of nerves known as autonomic nervous system. And you are not conscious of it. Probably you are eating this morning, or rather it is happening now. Digestion and absorption, they are not aware. And that is the role of the sweet muscle. The nervous system is the most complex of the nerves or the tiny nerves. This the neuron is the most complex, and because of the cerebral processes that are attached to it, dendrites or the axon. Axon is a very long process that is attached to it and delivers information from it. Whereas the other processes, short processes, known as the dendrite, they receive information. One fact is that each of us seated or standing is constituted by billions of cells or tiny lives. 70 to 100 billion of tiny lives make up the individual, the average human. And these tiny lives, they have a lifespan of about 70 years. And every minute, it's expected that a million will die, of course, particularly when age advances. This the cell and all this familiar. A cell has an outer lining, lining the plasma layer or the cell membrane. And all the contents of the activities of the cell are within that outer plasma layer. And that is the organs. Now, further,
this system,
like I have before, the tiny lives from conception, that is from fertilization, up to the time of the blastocyst, when the cells, the zygote, that is the outcome of the fertilized cell has divided to the top to the about cell stage when it forms a blastocyst. Each one is capable, is competent to produce the whole human being. That is why we are called totipotent cells. But after the stage of the blastocyst, the cells of the inner mass divide into three columns or three layers, which are ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. Now, each of them is pluripotent, divides into several other tissues, but not the whole world. And that is how it is. Totally, red blood cells, erythrocytes, have the highest, about 84% of the total number is red blood cells. And you can see the ranking of the cells. This is the stage of the formation. That stage is called gastrulation, the stage of the formation of germ layers. And this is I want to get to the stage of my area of emphasis, that is my contribution to knowledge, recent research focus. So it will permit me to see some of this. Our cells communicate with each other, and these are various ways that we can communicate, either directly or through chemical substances. And through chemical substances, they can extend between the range of separation of the cells. When they are directly involved, they exchange substances either out of the particular tiny life or into it, and what the environment is called exocytosis and endocytosis. It is also important to note that the tiny life has specialization on their luminal surfaces. The cells or the tiny labs, a luminal surface has, particularly for epithelial cells, a specialization in their functions. In the respiratory tract, they are referred to as cilia. And then the cilia, they breathe outward, so because when you breathe in, the cilia is important to exclude or filter the air you breathe, the air you breathe. And the same thing, for example, in the intestines, there are microvilli. The microvilli also assist in the absorption of substances within the system. And this is the structure of the cell membrane of the plasma membrane. It is a bilipid layer and functions so effectively in all the interactions with the cell. Now, this area is important, very important to me. My recent research findings. Now, cells, their activity is to advance that they utilize oxygen for the normal breathing that we do. Now, just like when you eat food, at the end of it, some are absorbed, the rest are evacuated, and they are not found. It is not a good sign to hold the excess that is not utilized, and they are avoided from the system. The same thing, the tiny labs, they utilize oxygen, and the products of the oxygen forms what they describe as reactive oxygen species, otherwise called radicals, free radicals. And these free radicals, if accumulated, are injurious to the cells. Now, the cells or the tiny labs also have inbuilt mechanisms by which they eliminate the free radicals. Now, the inbuilt mechanisms are called the antioxidants. The antioxidant free radicals with age, as one progresses in age, they are suppressed. Because the activities, they cannot freely eliminate as much as the free radicals that are produced by the tiny labs. And this is the area of my research focus. I've done a lot of medicinal plant activities. Now, medicinal plants, they have potential for providing substances within them that act as drugs, the general drugs that we all know. And this is one of the studies that we did ameliorating the effects of Lexidemia sativa on oxidative stress. I've mentioned to you what oxidative stress is. Now, this oxidative stress, they are natural phenomenon, and if not arrested, It can lead to self-death or lead to other dysfunctions of the self. It can be cancer, it can be diabetes. So many other things that can happen when there is dysfunction of the self because of the free radicals when they are in excess. Now, this plant has three names. We did this work in the north. There is a calcium name, Yadea, Isunachi is the legal name, and then Isunachi is the Yoruba name. Now, it's consumed locally by the chief. And they testify that it has anti-diabetic effect. That's when somebody takes it for the purpose of diabetes, it has the capacity to eliminate or reduce the chances of continuing in that state. Now, we did work in experimental rats where we introduced diabetes. Using the step to C, 50 milligram per kilogram body weight by IV intravenous. And that can establish diabetes. Now, when diabetes has been established, we use the plant to administer in various dose bottles. 100 milligram, 200 milligram. And then we have a control that we use insulin and 6 international units of insulin. Now, the overall, what we discovered was that the plant reduces blood glucose level. It also prevents diabetic weight loss. The plant also reduces some of the enzymatic factors, that is the enzymes that mimic illustrate oxidative stress. But when the markers, these enzymes, as you see, acetate transaminase, this is the mixed audience, and so forget about the major names, and those who understand will understand. And it also has the antioxidant effect by the SOD and the CAT that are increased in the volume and the blood. The overall effect is that it has anti-diabetic effect. It also prevents the weight loss and during diabetes. It is so effective for those who consume it for that purpose, for diabetic purposes. These are tables associated with the study. Now, the second study that we did is on the common onions that we utilize, onions. Now, the outback of the onions has a very special substance. Now, this substance is quercetin glycoside. Quercetin glycoside. Now, quercetin glycoside, we study the profiles. It is anti-inflammatory, it is antioxidant. It is also a particular, it has also that potency to eliminate a number of internal organ conditions. What we did was to create liver, the liver is the organ that does all the metabolic activities in the body. So we targeted the liver, we created liver, alcohol liver disease. Wilson. And we discover that he has this onions can reduce this disease to a very significant level.
Thank you. good. But for me, it makes no sense. That is it. So, it is also called 4 o'clock. Now, because it can keep the man awake, I mean, active from up to 4 o'clock in the night or early in the morning. So, that is recommended. Land.
Okay, they were up to like, let's say it's like used to 200 or something.
Students can do morphological Pastor Lenny Prince. I invited him and obliged. He has so much to do before him, but he obliged. And here he is. I appreciate God. I also invited Linda Brotsky from Maduro. You know you already. My family.
I was looking for where to hide, but
cross anatomy, developmental anatomy, and of course microscopic anatomy, among others. And if you draw attention to some key terms in human anatomy, these include resolution, magnification, and of course contrast. Then we talk about tiny lives and families before birth. According to him, tiny lives refer to the building blocks of tissues, organs, and organ systems, which are cells, while families refer to the composite tissues, organs, and organ systems of the human organism. We drew attention to the process for the formation of men and females, and stated that it contributes more to whether the couple will have a male or female child. And so this one is important for us. It's instructive, so that most communities will find people like blaming the woman, saying you're having only female children, not knowing that it's not the fault of the woman. And I'm sure we have learned a lot from that today. And then of course, we should also therefore not put the blame on the woman. And then he talked about reproductive technology, which includes IUI, intrauterine insemination, and then to in vitro fertilization, IVF, or intercept to plasmid sperm, that is ICSI. If you also pay attention to the fact that each individual is made up of millions of these tiny lives. And this decreases as we grow older, as some of them die with time. But the total number of cells in the human body is about 200. And then he talked about his cell focus. He stated that cells communicate with each other and exchange substances. He drew attention to the phytomedicinal impact of these cells and also the role of free radicals. He spoke about the anti-diabetic effects of the plants studied, and he also spoke about the medicinal properties of banyan peel, especially in respect of diseases relating to the liver. Mr. Good, ladies and gentlemen, another lecturer also spoke about the fact that onion is very good. It's a very good anti-inflammatory oxidant. So we should always have onions in our meal. Sometimes we should also even treat raw. He also spoke about his research on a plant which he called P. macrocerus, which enhances the potency of men. I think that if we have not learned anything from this lecture today, we need to remember that tiny lives can help men fulfill their conjugal obligations in the other room. That was really for me. In the other room. And then, of course, he made a number of recommendations. We talked about the need for the provision of a central laboratory at the university and the need to reduce our stress level or the volume of alcohol at the team. This one is not just for the fighters alone, it's for each and every one of us. And so that when we are working, let us remember that we need to guide ourselves accordingly. And then he talked about the need for the training of technical staff. And finally, he talked about commercial production of key ingredients from key medicinal plants that have antioxidants, anti-diabetic, and testicular enhancement activities. For us as a university, I'd like to say that these ones we take it to the director of IPPTU to see how we can get approval from the appropriate authorities so that we can actually urge private individuals and companies to support us to see how we can patent some of these innovations and techniques that he has suggested. It's a good place, and gentlemen, we can all see that we did not make a mistake at all in appointing Dr. Damotole Watson-Jacks as professor of microscopy.
Thank you, John. university anthem.
Amen.